Hey, welcome back. So continuing from the previous segment, just two things. That's what we are going to do. We will create a ppolicy overlay on the database. OlcDatabase database is equal to 1bdb under cn is equal to config branch. And then go ahead and define a password policy which would be applied to all the users who exist in the id, which actually exist under the suffix dc is equal to fetch g, dc is equal to com. But I have a problem, and this segment is about highlighting to you that problem, a problem that we're going to hit now and how we get over that problem. That's what we will be discussing in this segment and the next segment. I'm going to attempt adding the overlay, the ppolicy overlay onto my database. And once I do that, I want to see if it goes through fine first of all. Only then would I be able to add the new password policy under dc is equal to fetch g, dc is equal to com. I'm quite sure I'm going to hit a problem here, and that's what we're going to try and sort out. Let me run the command ldap modify minus d cn is equal to admin, comma cn is equal to config. I hope you remember the credential of cn is equal to admin. It is secret with e. And then what am I doing? I'm trying to add an overlay. So my DN would be overlay, OLC overlay is equal to ppolicy. You might remember this from my previous discussion on the audit log overlay and the access log overlay. This is the way we add an overlay. For what? For the database 1bdb under the branch cn is equal to config. Since I am adding this entry, the change type is add, and then I have to now define what are the object classes and what are the attributes that I want. So the object class is let's say object class is olc ppolicy config. That's the name of the object class. Now, in case if you are not very familiar with these object classes, you can always do an LDAP search on the cn is equal to config branch to identify what are the different object classes that exist, what are the different attributes that exist. We would specify the first attribute, which is olc overlay. The name of the overlay is ppolicy. We would also define olc ppolicy default. You remember this is the attribute that would point to the default password policy that I'm planning, which is, let's say, normal policy, comma dc is equal to fetch g, dc is equal to com. Agreed, this policy is not created yet. We would do that soon. Once this overlay goes through, the next step is to create this policy and then put that policy into the DID. And then finally, I would also say olc ppolicy hash clear text true. I'm going to show you the schema also so that you are familiar with this attribute. Now what this does is, I think the attribute itself is a clear indication on what it does. It would hash the clear text. So if I apply this overlay to the database there, anyone attempting to change his or her password, even if they supply a clear text, that's going to be converted to a hash. That is what that specific attribute does. Now let me hit enter twice. When I do that, it actually is pointing to something else. I don't believe I have made any kind of syntax error in what I have done there. To me, the entry, the LDIF format looks quite fine, but it is complaining to me that it is unable to find the pwd attribute on this directory server. Very clearly, it means that it is unable to search such attributes. Question, where are these attributes defined? The attributes are defined in the schema. Now, what does the schema contain? It contains both object class and the attributes that are defined by the object class. Now that we understood that it's complaining to us that such an attribute does not exist, we might want to have a look at what are the different attributes that exist in my current LDAP server. So let's do one thing. I will do an LDAP search operation using cn is equal to admin, cn is equal to config, supply the password. The base DN is, let's say, cn is equal to config. I want all the entries, object class is equal to asterisk. Now this output is going to be quite lengthy, so I'm going to redirect this output to, let's say, tmp ldap search.txt, supply that. Now let me edit this file. The output of the ldap search command has been redirected to tmp ldap search.txt. let me edit this file and search for pwd attribute. Oh, such an attribute, such a string, does not exist. Maybe olc overlay config. As you can see, that is an object class which I defined. And if I go ahead and look at the object class, what are the attributes that that it has? You can see olc, access log olc, all of that is there. Maybe I can also search for olc overlay ppolicy config. In fact, olc ppolicy config. Let me just verify if such an object class exists. You can see that there is an object class that says olc ppolicy config, which has olc overlay config as a superclass indicated by this particular line. And as you can see, this is an attribute that I used from that object class, which is olcp policy default, that was pointing to normal policy dc is equal to fetch g comma dc is equal to com. And also another attribute that I used was olcp policy hash clear text. So I think now it's clear where these attributes are coming from, where are the object classes defined. I looked at this DIT, but I was not able to find out the PWD attribute. Maybe I might search for PWD policy to see if an object class exists. Now this is not to be confused with the object class PWD policy. This is actually another attribute that exists. Apart from this attribute, I don't get to see anything in the name of PWD policy. So one thing is very clear: the attributes and the object class that are required for my password policies are not loaded onto the DIT yet. Those schema, the rules that define the attributes and the object classes that are required to define my password policy, are not there. So what we would confirm is run the LDAP search command, LDAP search minus D, CN is equal to admin, CN is equal to config, minus W, secret, minus B, DC is equal to, maybe I would say, CN is equal to schema branch. Look only there. CN is equal to config, object class is equal to asterisk, and then fetch me the DN of the schema. Let me break down this command for you. I'm authenticating myself as CN is equal to admin comma CN is equal to config, that happens to be the bind DN, supplied the password which is secret with E. Then I'm saying start the search, the base DN, start the search at CN is equal to schema comma CN is equal to config. Fetch me all the entries, but only give me the DN of those entries. I don't want a lengthy output here, I just want the DN. If I hit enter there, what I get to see is under the CN is equal to schema branch, there is only one schema that is loaded, and that one schema is the core schema. So no wonder I am not able to use the attributes that are defined in the password policy schema. Password policy schema is not loaded under the CN is equal to schema comma CN is equal to config branch. Let me just navigate to the directory etc openldap openldap.conf. Sorry, etc openldap. Under that there is a schema directory. If I hit ls here, I get to see a number of schema. Only one schema is loaded, which is actually core.schema, and that's what you see in the form of a DN here. Whereas the one that I want, which is ppolicy.schema, that defines all these attributes like pwd attribute, that is not loaded onto the CN is equal to config branch. I will just do a vi on the ppolicy.schema and search for pwd attribute and see if it exists. As you can see, the attribute exists there. So I know that is the file I want. Now it's only a question of loading this ppolicy.schema under the CN is equal to schema branch of CN is equal to config. Because the ppolicy schema is not loaded onto the CN is equal to schema comma CN is equal to config branch, we are not in a position to add the ppolicy overlay to the database branch. So in the next segment, we will fix this. We're going to load the schema, load the ppolicy.schema dynamically, that means without a reboot. Of course, you could do that by modifying the slapd.conf, but we are not going to rely on that. We will dynamically alter the CN is equal to schema branch to load one more schema, which is ppolicy.schema, so that we could make use of the attributes and the object classes of that schema. And then the overlay configuration would just go through fine, hopefully. So in the next segment, you will see how you could load the ppolicy.schema onto the cn is equal to schema, comma cn is equal to config branch.